Hello everybody and welcome back to another episode of City Skylines. We are in first person mode, checking out the ring road that goes around our city. This is actually a pretty impressive view from down here. Look at these roads, they look spectacular. And they are so high up you can actually put some parks underneath them is something that I found out. This game looks absolutely amazing. Love all the traffic, look at those garbage trucks going out to pick up all the trash. We are running a good city over here. As always, guys, love your support. Really do appreciate it. 2,000 likes, another episode tomorrow. I am really still just loving playing this game every day. It's ever so cool. I'm happy to make videos for you. And I've got a few comments on my last video from some new people, people who have just started watching the series. There is a playlist. Click that link in the description box if you want to check out the previous videos. This series is full of tips and tricks, some of those of which get revised episode by episode. This just looks amazing. This, I wish, was my screensaver, just some camera of the city going around. Not that I have a screensaver, this is 2015, don't think we use those anymore. But anyway, let's exit out of this and let's have a look at our city, because I have done some serious work in between episodes. Look at this, look at our population, 137,000 and rising. Our income here has come back up as well. If you remember in the last episode, I was having a little bit of trouble with this sort of flatlining around zero. And I finally realised what it was. You see, I was doing an experiment in this area that I kind of forgot about. So look at the expansion that we've done here. This has got to be 20, 25,000 people in this area. And while I was doing that, I put very little services down. We're talking the basic fire stations, and that was about it, I think. No schools, anything like that. So I went around and I added all of these services, as well as a ridiculous amount of parks. And the land value goes up, and then the amount of residents living in the building goes up. They start paying taxes, you put down the services, it all contributes to that, and it has an overwhelmingly positive effect. So it feels like the public services, as long as you won't do it, don't overdo it even, they tend to make money, which is really cool, because if you have a look here, there's just so many services in the city now, and they make a huge difference. I mean, look at how many fire stations we've got right there. Every time I added something down, the income just started to rise. Interesting stuff, isn't it? But there you go, I've been working on this area, and you may notice that although the traffic is heavy in this area, it's significantly better than when we left off last episode. Look at the flow of traffic into the city. It's not quite chock-a-block. Look at that, it's doing alright, isn't it? I've read some guides on traffic, and I've made some changes here in the city that I'm going to show you that are absolutely brilliant, because they made a huge difference. And by the way, should we put this university here in the middle? It really would suit. I saw a comment for that, and I thought, do you know what? It looks so nice in the middle, but this probably generates a fair bit of traffic. I don't know. That's one thing we might do. I'm also thinking about having... Oh, look at this. We've got a fair bit of traffic right there, don't we? And loads of those garbage trucks. But yeah, I'm thinking about making a few changes here and there. In fact, I did. What we need to do here, I've already done somewhere. Look. Where is it? Let's go around. I love all these little paths, by the way. So yeah, I've added an exit ramp in here, and that just seemed to alleviate a little bit of traffic from other areas. You know, there's an alternative exit. It's not the most optimal one, but people use it, and it doesn't drive a lot of traffic over there. So maybe we'll add some more of these exit ramps, and maybe even entrance ramps as well. But that could change the whole dynamic. Like, if we were to put in an entrance ramp, all of a sudden, one of our other ones might become... redundant. But let's not get too much into the traffic. We don't want to do that. By the way, I asked for some feedback about... Look at those dips over there. They look so silly. I asked for some feedback about these parks, by the way, and it seemed like just about everyone really liked the idea of using the custom parks, regardless of their effect. What's this one right here? It's the baseball park. I don't think that's really going to fit in the middle of the park, is it? Or in this area, so we're not going to put that in. But yes, overwhelming support for those. I think we're going to avoid the obviously cheaty ones, like that little pool that has a huge area of effect and a minimal cost. But anyway, let's start to talk about what we're doing in this episode. We are going to be doing something that's been heavily requested for a while, and that is to build the cargo bay. We're going to start doing something with ships. We're going to be building one of those and distributing raw materials into our industrial area, which could probably do with an expansion. If we have a look over here, all of those underworker problems and raw materials have seemed to disappear, with the exception of that one right there. Actually, let's speed up the city a little bit. When you look at it and traffic's moving slow, it's sometimes hard to see how it's getting slowed down. You can see here our roundabout in the middle, heavily congested, may need to make some changes there. Also, we have a huge demand for commercial and industrial at the moment, which is interesting. Might need to build another office district at some point. But anyway, let's go and talk about the changes that I've made, because from up here, you can't see them at all. Let's click on this tab right here. Let's open up our bus lines and check that out. I pretty much deleted every single route that we had in the city beforehand and decided to rebuild all of them. So I read this guide that talked about the way to set up routes, and the idea that it talked about was having localized bus lines where you don't have a lot of stops. You generally just go, you know, around in a loop or up and down in a line, and you connect to a metro station. So that's what I've done. You can see here we actually have two lines, one on either side of the road, which is one of the principles it talked about. So that goes all the way around our main area right here and then down into the metro. Now, if I'd have known about this before, one of the things I could have done to help with the bus stops is to have little pedestrian paths cutting up the main roads. For example, from this bit right here, you could have a pedestrian path going up onto the hill, and then there's a bus stop right there. And why can I hear a strange sound effect noise? What is that I'm actually hearing? Never mind, that's I can't even describe what I just heard, but it didn't sound right to me. Maybe it got captured on the video. Maybe we're just imagining things. It looks like there's a space there for a path, except I think there's actually a park. But anyway, it's one of those things that you can do. I think, like, what we might try and do is some high-tech kind of planning of zones in the future where we lay everything out based on bus routes and metro stations as well, because you can just make a big difference like that. So here's another ring road, you know, not a lot of stops, goes around in a circle. It's going to get around that entire route very fast, and it's going to drop people off here where they can walk to the metro. And the same thing goes for the other side. It kind of goes into the middle a little bit as well, but it goes in a circle. We've also got this route here in what we call Squeeze Grove, where it goes through the whole neighborhood and then over to the metro over here, and then it swings back around and comes back in again. So you've got these very efficient lines that just basically connect an area to the metro. And so the increase in traffic that we've seen, our buses have gone from 2,200 up to 3,400, and I think our metro is 1,500, and it's up a little bit. So it's nothing too dramatic, but it's certainly making a difference. And I also put the budget of our buses up, because all we need to do is have the one station, and it seems to provide enough buses for the entire city. So that's a little bit more expensive, and that seemed to help boost the traffic as well. Or when I say traffic, what I mean is the usage of the buses. Now, I think the figure you want to aim for is 5 to 10% of your total city population. So 13 being the optimal, we're about, well, 7 being about 5%, we're about halfway there. So we're not even where the game, or the game creator said, is the optimal area for your buses to have, you know, passengers. Wow, I'm really struggling with words all of a sudden. Hopefully that made sense. Let me just rephrase that. We're about 2.5% of our entire population using the buses, when apparently 5 to 10% is the optimal amount for the game. And that's what the creator said themselves. So, interesting stuff. It means we've probably got to tweak the bus lines a little bit. Another thing I did, by the way, to give it a bit of character was give them all names based on the area they're in. So some of them are called, like, the Ring. Like, Magnolia Ring goes around the Magnolia area. The residential one just goes through the residential part. And all of these just, you know, connect to a metro station as well. And there's a few others, like the Croft Connect, that just takes our rich area over here to the metro station and then back again. And I think any other line that just has connect like that is just one that basically connects an area over to a metro, because it doesn't have one, which is pretty cool. So a lot of buses come through here. If we inspect the streets, you'll probably see them coming through quite often and dropping people off, which is really good to see. It's going ever so well. I love it. And yeah, that's the big change that I made. In terms of the metro lines don't really feel that great. I've only got a few of them, as you can see over here. And with that line underneath there, the way it's all laid out, you know, the metro tunnels and all of these other colours everywhere, it was kind of like difficult to really map out in my mind where I wanted each of the routes to go. So I put down a fair few that kind of just go all over the place, really. And it's kind of hard to show you that, as you can see right here. So if we go select none, and then I click on that Avalon loop, where does that go? And I tick that, we should see a red path. I can't even see it in the metro, so yeah, basically there's a whole bunch of tracks that go all over the place. So I was trying to make it so that they so that they go, let's say, like, some go around in a circle between, like, a lot of stops, and some just go back and forth between the commercial hub or the industrial area, and I haven't seen a massive boost with that, so maybe the layout of our city isn't too optimal for it, but that's what I've been doing in between episodes. That took a while to explain, just loads of re-trafficking and also expanding this city. I'm going to add some more services in here. In fact, we are going to do a little bit of an experiment. It's one I want to turn down the speed for, because I am recording at the same time. I see a lot of you recommending that we should turn up the taxes. Let's actually open up the right tab. So we click on that. Note, we click on that one, then click on this, the commercial hub. I think we should make this outlying area part of it as well. But for now, what we're going to do in the city planning... No, is that it? Taxation? We're going to raise the taxes for the high-density commercial and the low-density commercial. And that should make us a lot more money immediately. Oh, look at the average land value. Did that? No, it didn't change. Never mind, ignore me. That's quite a useful tool, though, when you're clicking on districts. Like 49 over here, 47, 59, 45. Maybe there's like a connection between the two where you can see the number of the land value and then go, aha, that means that I can tax it a little bit more. But anyway, we're going to tax this area. What I'm expecting to see is complaints about the taxes. And my response to that is going to be to put down some parks, to put down some more services, and to try and combat it by increasing the land value and the value of these houses while they're complaining about the taxes. So perhaps then they'll go, actually, you know what, you can tax us more because the city's improving. That's my plan. We're going to do that. That's a temporary experiment we'll do right now. And then we're going to move on to the actual thing we're doing in this episode, which is the cargo bay. Okay, I built another one of our unique buildings over here. This is the stadium. It costs 4,000 a week. Quite pricey. Not really sure if this is the best place to put it, as it's a tourist attraction. But we'll see how it goes. It didn't really increase the land value or help any of the buildings around it. In fact, some of them had negative smileys. That would probably be from noise. That would be these buildings right here, which wasn't the effect that we wanted. But anyway, I had to remove the tax policy on the low commercial stuff. They didn't like it. I put in a park in each section as well. Let's just click on the parks tool so you can see that made a big difference. Just one park in each area. And by the way, there was a sort of mechanic, or you could call it a bug in the game, but it was intended that parks would reduce the desire for commercial. But they changed that in a recent patch. So now putting parks in the middle of your commercial should be okay. And down the front here, we lost a few skyscrapers because there were just a couple of high-density buildings that weren't happy with the tax prices. But apart from that, the rest of them are pretty good, and they're pretty close to upgrading to the top level as well. So there's just like one more thing that we need in this area, and I can't think of what it is because these are already doing ever so well. Maybe another bus line, because that always throws down lots of positives. So maybe I'll add... I mean, we've already got, you know, exactly what we need from the buses, so I don't know what exactly it is we would do. Maybe just a simple outer ring road like this that connects up to the metros. Let's do that and let's see if that makes a difference. Oh yeah, the reason they don't go around this bit is because it's a one-way road system, so I'm not sure what it is I'll do. I think maybe it's time to move on to the cargo. So what have I been calling this thing? The cargo bay? It's the cargo harbour. This is like the equivalent of this thing right here, the cargo train terminal. And it's going to bring in raw materials for our industry to use. So that means we're going to have to hook it up to the industry. Now there's a number of places that we're going to... we could put this. It's interesting to see actually where you can put it. There has to be a straight line just over to this point right here. You can't put it over here and expect the boats to go around that side. So the place we're going to put it is just over here. I'm pretty sure there's no need for me to change that. We're going to put it down a fair bit just so it's out of the way at the edge of the city there, the noise bit, and then this thing is obviously going to need power. Don't worry about that. Here's what we're going to do. We are going to hook this up to a train line that we're going to make using one of these, which we just talked about, a cargo train terminal. So this thing needs to be put on a road, and we're going to make a circular road down here. Now the deal is this is going to bring in some materials that's going to generate trucks down here. So if we add ourselves a road that goes like this in a square, and then we put the train track on this side, it's going to generate trucks. They're going to go over to the cargo bay and then back round to there again. That should literally be it, an isolated little circle of traffic that these two generate between them. So if we put that right there, you can see that all the cargo is going to come in. We're going to unload it, and then it's going to go into this one. Now there may be a cause here for Some bigger roads, you know, denser ones based on how much traffic comes out of here, so we might tweak this. But that's pretty much it, that's all we need. Obviously they need power to get running and some water as well. But now what we can do is make a train track that we can then hook up to this bit. So what we might do is, like we did on this side, have another one of those just going over the edge. That'll look ever so cool. Let's actually build that quickly. So we can cut into the side like that. Oh, that looks good straight away. We can go under the bridge. Oh yes, that's nice. Oh, that looks really cool. Look at our, like, canal that we've got here. In fact, this bit looks a little bit odd. Let's just delete that and rebuild it. It might not be possible because of the angle this comes at, so let's just come back a step and see if that's going to do it again. It is going to do it again. Let's try and carve more into the cliffside like that. Is that going to do it? Ah, there we go. We did it. Oh, that looks so nice, doesn't it? That really does. That turned out very well. So this has to connect with the cargo line. We have a look over here. We have a cargo bay here. We have a track that then goes up the top and into this place. So it can connect to either two of those. If we put another track alongside this one, we could bring it in somewhere over here. Alternatively, we can come across the side here and connect it up. So I've got to make a decision. I'm not sure what way we're going to connect it here. Okay, this is how we're going to connect it. We've got the junction right there, and it goes behind the poop dam over here. Again, I get comments about this, it feels like every video. The purpose of this dam is to hold back the poopy water from our nice water, and you can see the way I've done the track. But this looks so cool. I love the canal here. It just looks really great with the tracks on either side, and even the train track going over as well. Oh, it's ever so cool. Love this. Anyway, we come over here, you can see we've got a little bit of a problem. We need ourselves some power. So how are we going to get that over there? Probably just going to connect it up to this main line rather than do anything fancy going across the water. We've already covered that over here. In fact, that looked like it was part of the bridge a moment ago. I thought those support struts were connected to the bridge, but actually it's not, is it? There we go. That's cool. So this thing's got power. Now it needs water. Except it's already got the water. That's brilliant. Okay. I wondered why we didn't have that error message. So now we're just going to sit here. A building is on fire. That's fine. Don't worry about it. we're going to speed up the game. I think this has got everything that it needs to operate. Let's have a look. Cargo harbour. Allow ships to carry goods and raw materials. Operating normally. Okay. So this is very expensive, but apparently it's all good. So I guess we're just going to have to wait for a ship to come in. Okay, we got our first ship coming in. This didn't happen until after I attached this road to over here, which was mainly for these guys to come and pick up the rubbish this thing has generated. And look at that, there we go. I'm a little worried about these guys going out into the city at this point, but look at that. They're all going straight over there, and that's exactly what we wanted. And this is what I was expecting to see. I was thinking maybe there would be a little bit more. What happened to the ship? That thing disappeared quickly, didn't it? Oh no, there's another one coming back in. Where did the ship go? I didn't actually pay attention to that. Okay, well, we've got another one coming in right here. We're going at the fastest speed, by the way. And I didn't see a single lorry there leave the city, which means that this should be working the way I was hoping it to work. Okay, so in comes this guy. Hooks up with the dock. Zoom in and check that out. This will look really cool from first person view. Okay, so it starts. Okay, so the boat just disappears like that. Fair enough, fair enough. Oh, you see, this one is going out to the city. That's not what I wanted it to do. I wanted it to go straight over to this one. So the occasional truck is going to go out into the city. Now, I'm wondering if now that we've got this, if rather than just bringing in random stuff, the game is now, like, in a sense, querying all of the businesses over here, or industries, as we would call them, and finding out what they need. And that's why they're now heading out that way instead of using this, because the game has, like, calculated that actually we're going to send a truck out rather than use the cargo line. Apparently this thing can only hold so much cargo as well. I'm not sure how you see that. So maybe when it's full it has to go and send a truck out on its own. But there you go. So is there another boat coming in? There is. What we're going to do is press that magic button and zoom right here and stand on the dock to watch this in action. It's going to look real cool. So the perspective is pretty nice. That is a very sharp turn for a boat. Some crazy manoeuvring right there. This looks so cool. Look at the detail on the front there. And then, boom, it disappears. Amazing. Oh, this is so cool. I really like it. Cool, so that should help out with our raw materials in this area over here. It's funny, because a moment ago, I went and checked on it, and we got loads of complaints. And I'm just wondering if now that we've added this, It means that there's a larger availability of raw supplies, and now they're complaining because it's taken a while to get over there. But hopefully those should go away. Not enough raw materials. We should have lots of trucks leaving these places now and delivering them. I'm assuming that's where they're going to go. Like, over to that station. Maybe they just leave the world or something. But let's follow this guy and find out. Oh, it looks so cool going down the canal here. Trains on either side. Amazing stuff. Up to the poop dam. Oh, and around it goes. Such a cool looking game, isn't it? Very nice. So you're going to go right or left? You're going straight over, which is left. And yeah, I'm expecting him to stop here and then to go back again. But he might leave the place. Let's see what he does. Unloading the cargo. Oh, that's cool. Nice little animation there. Is that it? And then he's going to go back. So I unloaded like two of those containers. And now you can see the trucks are going in. Very cool stuff. Let's see how much it costed us. Costed us. That is probably not the correct English. So 1.9. That's not bad. But our budget is very high. It feels like, you know, as I was saying earlier, when you add stuff, it just adds more to the city. And means it can generate more money as well. So it kind of pays for itself. And look at the Statue of Industry. That thing looks ever so cool. Okay, tax complaints and abandoned buildings are never good. Let's do something a little bit risky here. Let's click on this. Let's turn off that and actually go to our entire budget over here and raise the taxes everywhere by 1%. Because those raise it by 2, which might be just too much. And I'm going to guess we'll get widespread complaints about the taxes when we do this. But these 1% could make a huge difference considering just how many of each there are now in our city. So up they go, all of them very carefully adjusted by 1%. And look at this thing. Is it going to jump up more than that? It should jump up. It should rocket up is what I'm expecting. It's at 16,000, 17, 19. There we go. There it's going. 20,000, 21. That's good. Okay, and I'm not seeing a single complaint yet. It might take a while. 25,000. That's amazing. It's a moneymaker. Just raise the taxes. Obviously, we'll probably get some complaints somewhere, but I'm not seeing anything at the moment, which is a good sign. 30,000. That's incredible. All right, I'll keep my eye on the city, and hopefully that'll work out for us. So I've lowered the residential taxes by 1. That's the low density. This area right here was complaining. If we just have a look at the land value, you see there it's 48, whereas over here it's 59, and there were no complaints in that area, so they're definitely linked. I guess maybe something we could try and do is increase the land value. Okay, now other things are starting to complain. That's not great, because some of this is high density. And, oh wait, is that an office? Kind of looks like an office. Let's have a quick look at that. Yes, it's an office. Huh, I didn't realise. I thought that was a commercial building. Anyway, it looks like it's not going to work. Let's turn down offices as well. So while the city is on tax watch, this area right here has expanded. You can see some big buildings appearing. That's really good. That means that we're doing well in this area. But one thing that I've noticed is since I've added these ramps right here, they generate a fair bit of traffic, which may seem all right. But if you have a look at these roads, our actual exits, they're completely empty. And we've designed this inner ring road area to kind of accommodate for people leaving in this direction. So if they're not, we kind of want to force them back there. And I think that might sound like a bad plan at the moment, but once we do so, we may see a lot of this traffic here sort of decongest as loads of it streams out the same way. So we're going to remove these off ramps that I've added. They were an experiment. They certainly generate a lot of traffic, but it means those roads are empty and they're there for that reason. So we're going to remove these, and what I might do is put a couple of these ramps maybe on the very outskirts of these areas. So for example, like here, what if we have a one-way exit? That might actually just mean a few people from this area will use that rather than everyone in this area, where they should be using the exit ramps that we have provided them with. That should make sense, I think. Anyway, let's do this and see what happens. All right, the city has stabilized with our new tax rates. And I was just thinking, you know, we've pushed it up by 1, had to lower some back by 2. What if they were all 11 by default and we bumped them up 2 using districts? I'm even thinking of trying that over here, maybe going up to 14%. For this area, but our budget is good. I added in another police station over here. This area is doing very well, and the traffic experiment seems to have worked. You can see there's a steady outflow over here. I've noticed that these roads are pretty bad. I can't remember if I showed you this Ah, this is very important. Yes, I think I did this off camera. We have a highway ramp right here. Put a little road off to the side so we could just upgrade this small section. And now it means that there's no traffic lights. So everything kind of just converges rather than creating a load of traffic back down here. So the traffic looks kind of similar. Not quite as heavy, which is good. And on this side, look, there's barely any traffic going up there compared to the other side. But it's good. And there's more experiments to be done. I think that was a good one, deleting those ramps. But there you go, the city is looking amazing. We've got our first cargo harbour over here. We hooked that up correctly. And actually, if we look at it now, you can see that a fair few trucks are heading into the city, which is not exactly what we wanted. Maybe they're bringing in too many for this thing. Maybe we need a second one, who knows. But it's doing something, which is better than it doing nothing. That's going to be it for this episode. If you enjoyed it, please do leave a like. As always, thank you very much for your support. It's greatly appreciated. But that's it from me this episode. There'll probably be another one tomorrow because you guys are great. So I'll catch you then. But for now, bye-bye.